Greetings of the day to everyone. This is the video for class 9th, chapter 4, structure of atom. This is the third part. So, I hope all of you must be fine at home and taking a very good care of yourself and your family members. In this video, we are going to discuss about valency, isotopes, isobars, uses of isotope, etc. So, let's start with valency. We have discussed about the different models suggested by J.J. Thomson, Rutherford, Niels Bohr and their experiments also. We have discussed earlier. We have also discussed about the electronic configuration and how the electrons are filled inside the atom. Now let's discuss about the valencies. What is valency actually? Valency is the number of electrons that an atom can gain, lose or share will be its valency. I'll explain you more with one simple example. If I'm talking about sodium, then sodium is having atomic number 11. So, as I have told you, atomic number is always equal to number of electron is always equal to number of protons, right? So, how the electrons will be filled in it? What will be the electronic configuration? 2, 8, 1. So, all the electrons want to complete their valence shell. The outer shell is known as the valence shell, and because they are having the sodium is having only one electron in its valence shell, then ye jo ek electron hai ye kisi ko donate kar dega. Okay, it will lose this one electron, and when we lose something, we give something to someone, we become positively charged. So, because it is providing one electron to someone, so it will be having one positive charge. Okay, so what is the valency of sodium? That is 1. If I talk about calcium, calcium comes at number 20. So, what will be the electronic configuration? 2, 8, 8. How many are remaining? 2, 8, 10 plus 8, 18. 2 are remaining. So, how many electrons it is having in its valence shell? It is having 2. So, will it take 6 electrons from someone or will it give these 2 electrons to someone? It will give these 2 electrons to someone. Okay? So, jab ye 2 electron de dega, to iske upar kya charge rahega? Plus 2. Alright, so calcium will be having the charge of plus 2. Okay, so this is about valency. Few more examples we will discuss now. So I hope that the definition must be clear to you for valency. That the combining capacity of the atoms of element, that is their tendency to react and form molecules with atoms of the same or different element. है ना, हो सकता है वो हाइड्रोजन हाइड्रोजन के साथ ही बॉन्ड बनाए, हो सकता है हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन के साथ बॉन्ड बनाए, राइट? हो सकता है हाइड्रोजन कार्बन के साथ बॉन्ड बनाए और मिथेन बनाए, राइट? तो इट डिपेंड्स. ओके, alright, so what they are forming, whether they are forming molecule with atom of same or different element, and it was thus explained as an attempt to attain a fully filled outermost shell. Okay, everybody wants to fill their valence shell. So an outermost shell that has 8 electron was said to possess an octet. Right? हर कोई अपना outermost orbit में 8 electrons octet complete करना चाहता है. And इसीलिए atoms जो हैं वो इस तरीके से react करते हैं so as to achieve an octet in the outermost shell, ताकि वो 8 electrons complete हो जाएं. Alright? So how they'll do this? By sharing, gaining or losing the valence electron. So the number of electron, whatever they are share, whatever are shared, gained or lost, so as to make the octet of electron in the outermost shell, gives us directly the combining capacity of the element. Okay, so you can call valency the combining capacity of the element. All right. Valence electron, agar 4 kya? 4 से लेस है देन इट्स वैलेंसी विल बी सेम एज दैट ऑफ नंबर ऑफ वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओके बिकॉज इट विल डोनेट दैट इफ आई टॉक अबाउट एल्यूमिनियम बिकॉज एल्यूमिनियम कम्स एट नंबर 13 सो इट इज हैविंग 13 इलेक्ट्रॉन सो व्हाट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन 2, 8, 3 सो बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग द वैलेंसी लेस देन 4 So, what will be? It is having only 3 electrons in the outermost shell, so it will donate 3 electrons and it will be having 4 plus 3 charge with them. Okay? Example 2nd for carbon, if I talk about carbon, is having atomic number 6. So, number of electrons will be 6, number of proton will be 6 so electronic configuration will be 2n4 okay so the number of valence electrons are 4 isliye carbon ki valency bhi kya ho jayegi 4 okay if I talk about fluorine comes at number yes 9 so how many electrons it will be having 9 so electronic configuration will be 2 7 How many electrons are needed? 1. तो जब ऐसा होता है कि वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जो होते हैं वो ज़्यादा होते हैं मोर देन 5 देन यूजुअली व्हाट दे डू दे टेक द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम समवन एंड गेट नेगेटिवली चार्ज ओके सो हेयर इट विल बी हैविंग नेगेटिव चार्ज ओके फ्लोरीन की वैलेंसी क्या हो गई 1+1 ओके जिन एलिमेंट्स का वैलेंस शेल कंप्लीट होगा दैट मींस कोई ऑक्टेन कंप्लीट होगा या फिर इनर शेल जो के शेल है वो कंप्लीट होगा देन दे विल रिएक्ट एज the inert element their valency will be 0 so up to 20 number helium neon and argon are having their valency 0 okay and if I talk about phosphorus shows 2 valency 3n5 okay so this is the question for regarding valency We have to find out the valency of sulfur. So the number of electrons in sulfur are 16. As we know, it comes at number 16. Electronic configuration 16 ke according kya hoga? 2, 8, 10 and 6. So how many electrons are needed to complete the octane? 2 electrons. So it will be having the valency 2. Okay. Now let's discuss about atomic number and atomic mass. Atomic number. It is the number of protons which are present in the nucleus of an atom and is called atomic number. We denote it with Z. Okay. So here are the few elements, right? And these are the atomic numbers. Okay. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, zinc. These are the elements and they are having a proper atomic number. So they are having a proper sequence and we cannot change this sequence. We have to learn it in this sequence only. Okay. So can we say that the number of proton of an atom determines its atomic number? And for atoms, the atomic number are always equal to the number of protons, which is denoted with Z. So atomic number is always equal to number of proton is always equal to number of electrons, right? But it is just in the case of atoms, not in the case of ions. Why not in the case of ion? Can you think? Why not in the case of ions? Right, let me tell you. Because if I talk about ion, then ion, what is ion? Either which is which has donated electron or gained the electron or lose the electron. Okay, so it will be having charge on it. Simply, if I talk about magnesium, alright, so magnesium comes at number 12, so it is having the electronic configuration 2A2, okay, so here because atomic number is 12, number of electron will be 12, proton will be 12. This is for atom. Now if I am talking about magnesium ion, because it is having 2 electrons in its outer shell, so it will be having valency this. Now what in this case? In this case, when it is having the charge of plus 2, that means it has given 2 electrons to someone, then Mg plus 2, now it will be having number of electron 10 and number of proton is still 12. Are you getting my point? So what will be the atomic number? It will be 12 only. Okay, so atomic number is always equal to number of proton and it is always equal to number of electron also in the case of atoms, but not in case of ions. Alright, now mass number. What is mass number? Neutron plus proton. Okay, so the mass number is defined as the sum of total number of protons plus neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. Alright, so mass number ko kis se denote karte hain? A se. So mass number A is equals to number of proton plus neutron. Okay, protons and neutron, what they are collectively known as? They are collectively known as nucleons. What they are known as? Nucleons. Okay, mass number aluminium ka kitna hai? 27 mu, right? What is the mass number of aluminium? 27 mu, because it comes at number 13.
So proton will be thirteen only, and as I already know that mass number is always equal to number of proton plus neutron. Okay, that means if I am having 27 as mass and if I am aware that 13s are the number of proton, can I find out this number of neutrons? Yes, I can. What I will do? 27 is equals to 13 plus n. 27 minus 13 is equal to n. So what will be the number of neutron? That will be 14. All right. So this is the atomic mass, and this is the way how to find out number of neutrons if you are aware about the atomic mass. Okay, so to calculate, if I have to calculate the number of neutrons for oxygen, because I know that oxygen comes at number 8, so number of electrons will be 8, number of protons will be 8, and its atomic mass is 16 mu. So what will be the number of neutron? Number of neutron will be atomic mass subtracted with the number of protons. So the number of neutron will be 8 only. Okay, I hope this must be clear to you. Alright. Mass number, atomic number agar even hai to hum mass kaise nikal sakte hain? We just have to multiply that atomic number into 2. If I talk about helium, what I am telling you, you have to multiply with 2 to the atomic number. You will simply get the mass. Okay, mostly this is the same case if I talk about carbon, then it comes at number 6 and mass is 12 mu. So even number, you just have to double them or multiply them with 2 only. Okay, if I have to take it out for odd number, I just have to multiply it, the atomic number, into 2, and then whatever, if I am getting x, then I have to do plus 1 into that and I will get the answer. Okay, so this is the mass number. Alright, so in the notation for an atom, the atomic number, mass number and symbol of the element are to be written in this form. How we have to write? If I'm assuming that x is the symbol for that element, then what I'll write on the upper side, this, what is A? A is denoting the atomic mass over here, and Z is denoting the atomic number. Okay, let's solve out this question based on mass number. The question is, what is the valency of an atom having 4 protons and 5 neutrons? Okay, 4 neutrons and 5 neutrons. You have to find out the valency. As we know that valency depends on only the electrons being shared or gained or lost. Okay, so number of atomic number is always equal to number of electron is always equal to number of proton for an atom. Okay, so if it is having 4 protons, then it will be having 4 electrons also, right? So with 4 electrons we are having the element beryllium, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. So what will be the electronic configuration for beryllium? It will be 2 2. Okay, so how many electrons it is having in its valence shell? 2. So what will be the valency? It will be 2 only. Okay, now our next topic is isotopes. Okay, what are isotopes? See, isotopes are the atoms of same element having same atomic number but different mass number. A very simple example I'll provide you for hydrogen. Hydrogen is having 3 isotopes, which could be written like this. Okay, protium, deuterium and tritium. Alright, so these are the 3 different isotopes for hydrogen. Now let's discuss these 3 isotopes. If I talk about protium, and it is having 1H1. So number of electrons are 1, because we write atomic number in as a subscript and atomic mass as a superscript. So it is having 1 electron, 1 proton, because atomic number is 1. Because its atomic mass is 1, so atomic mass 1 minus number of proton 1. So 1 minus 1, number of neutron will be 0 in this. If I talk about deuterium, deuterium is having number of electron 1, because atomic number written over here is 1, proton will be 1. Now neutron will be 2 minus 1. What is this 2? This is the atomic mass. So atomic mass minus the number of protons, because atomic mass is equal to proton plus neutron. So 2 minus 1, neutron will be 1. If I talk about tritium, then it is having 1H3, electron 1, proton 1, neutron 2, 3 minus 1, 2. Okay, so these are the 3 isotopes of hydrogen. Same atomic number but different atomic mass because of different number of neutrons in them. Alright. One more example for carbon we can give. Carbon is also found in the 2 isotopic form, that is carbon 12 and carbon 14. Okay, similarly fluorine also occurs in 2 isotopic forms, that is and 37. Okay, so these are the 2 for chlorine and these are the 2 for carbon. Okay, So these are all isotopes. Isotopes are having their own importance. They are important. Where they are important, let's discuss their importance now. And fractional mass also I'm going to discuss for chlorine. So let's discuss the fractional mass first. See, chlorine do isotopic form mein milta hai hamein, 35 mu or 37 mu. Okay, as I have told you now. And we found it in the ratio of 3:1. Okay, we get them in the ratio of 3:1. So, can I say that this 3:1 is all equal to 75% and 25%? Okay, so if I'm getting 75% of this isotope plus, what I have to do to find out the mass, I have to take out the average. Okay, wait, and again I'll do 37 into 25 upon 100. Okay, so now let's solve it out. What I have written over there, 35.7 का कितना परसेंट है, 75%, और 37 का कितना है, 25%, बिकॉज परसेंटेज है तो हमने नीचे जीरो लगा दिया. ओके, 3:4:1:4. ओके, सो व्हाट आई गॉट सिंपली 105/4 प्लस 37/4. Now 4 taking common, 105 plus 37, so I'll get 142/4. If I'll divide this, I'll get 35.5 mu. Okay, so this will be the fractional mass for chlorine. Fractional mass unhi ka nikalta hai jinke isotopes hote hain. आया समझ में? ओके, आई होप अब क्लियर हो गया होगा आप सबको. अगर किसी एलिमेंट के कोई आइसोटोप नहीं है तो उसका जो मास होगा, एटम का जो मास होगा, वही जो होगा वुड बी द सेम एज द नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स इन इट. ओके, बट इफ एन एलिमेंट अगर इन आइसोटोपिक फॉर्म, देन वी हैव टू नो द परसेंटेज ऑफ ईच आइसोटोपिक फॉर्म एंड देन द एवरेज मास इज कैलकुलेटेड. ओके, नाउ वेयर दीज आर आइसोटोप्स आर यूज्ड. आइसोटोप को हम यूरेनियम का जो आइसोटोप है उसे न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर्स में यूज़ करते हैं. कोबाल्ट का जो आइसोटोप है वो कैंसर के ट्रीटमेंट में यूज़ होता है. आयोडीन का आइसोटोप गोइटर के ट्रीटमेंट में यूज़ होता है. विच आइसोटोप इज़ यूज फॉर ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कैंसर? यस, कोबाल्ट. कोबाल्ट 60 इज यूज, okay, for the treatment of cancer. Alright, now isobars. What are isobars? See, isobars, these are the atoms of different elements with different atomic number but same atomic mass. Let me clear you this concept. If I talk about argon and calcium, argon comes at number 18, calcium comes at number 20. What are these? There are their atomic number. Okay, so if I talk about mass, then both of them having the mass 40 mu. Kya number of electron barabar hai? Nahi. Calcium ke andar 20 electrons honge aur isme 18 electrons honge. ओके, सो व्हाट इज सेम इन दैट, द एटॉमिक मास. सो नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी 18 फॉर कैल्शियम, प्रोटॉन विल बी 18 एंड नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स फॉर कैल्शियम विल बी 22 एंड दैट ऑफ, सॉरी, इट विल बी 20 ओनली okay, and it could be more than this, right? Okay, for argon it will be 22, for calcium it will be 20. Okay, so how I have find out the number of neutrons? By subtracting it from the atomic mass. What I have subtracted from atomic mass? The number of protons. Alright, because atomic mass is equal to proton plus neutron. I hope isobars also must be clear with you guys. Okay, so this is our chapter. We have discussed this chapter. Little bit more I want to tell you how to learn. Once again I want to tell you how to learn these this periodic table up to 20 very comfortably. So let me tell you a trick again. Okay, so this is the trick. Ha, he, lebeb, kenhoff, ni, namgal, sips, klar, kaka. Okay, so learn the periodic table in proper sequence and keep on doing your studies on regular basis. Thank you so much.